I've spent a good amount of time staring at the picture of the Bellarmine College prep football team that shows the majority of players standing and a handful kneeling for the national anthem. It's a poignant shot that mixes resignation, determination, and a teenage impatience to play the game. Now an assistant coach primarily responsible for the junior varsity has announced he is resigning from his varsity duties because of the players' protest. He will continue to coach the JV team for the rest of the season, but he says neither he nor his family will go to varsity games. Sadly, the clash might be inevitable. The assistant, Jacob Malai, is a sergeant with the Santa Clara Police, as well as a star Bellarmine lineman a quarter century ago. For more Bay Area high school sports coverage, follow Bay Area Preps on Flipboard. And the players' statement to explain their action, while praising the sacrifice of police, cited the continued failure of some members of law enforcement and our justice system to protect the marginalized. So is this the natural outgrowth of the Colin Kaepernick protest that began a year ago? An assistant coach who believes in standing for the anthem feels obligated to stop coaching the varsity team he loves because some of the players are taking a knee? Get top headlines in your inbox every afternoon. Get the free PM Report newsletter. Sign up. The optimist in me wants to believe that this is a teachable moment, and Bellarmine President Chris Meyercourt has tried to guide the discussion toward that goal, holding a campus town hall meeting at lunch to let everyone air their views. What is clear to us is that we are called to respond, that we are called to respond in love, that we are called to respond with compassion, and that we are called to seek greater understanding, Meyercourt wrote in a note to the Bellarmine community. Have a comment about this? Join the conversation from San Jose, the Bay Area, and beyond at our Facebook page. And yet Bellarmine is not immune from the passions roiling the rest of the country. Before the team's game against Sarah on September 29, which Bellarmine lost 480, a number of players took a knee during the anthem to protest injustice. By kneeling, we hope to express our dissatisfaction with our society's failure to uphold the values of justice, equality and peace, their statement said in part. Malai's resignation letter, which challenged the Bellarmine administration's handling of the issue, was no less eloquent. Traditionally, JV coaches also help with the varsity. Challenge these young men to be stewards of the best of Jesuit schools, seek truth, be intolerant of injustice, but do so in a way that everyone wins, he wrote, arguing that the act of taking a knee creates division rather than dialogue. So who is right? My sympathies are with the students. As the son of a Lutheran minister, I see taking a knee not as a rejection of country, but as a prayer to make it better. It's a far better gesture than Kaepernick's original decision to remain on a chair. And yet I don't think we can dismiss Malai's feelings or experience. Here is a man who has worked hard for his high school, who clearly cares about kids, and who comes to a different conclusion. We cannot condemn him for acting from conscience. I happen to think Malai is wrong in urging the Bellarmine administration to stop the protest. It's far better to engage feelings of injustice rather than to ignore them. And yet I hope that the focus on inequality doesn't interfere with the players doing what they were gathered to do in the first place, play football. Go Bells!